My name is Vida Villunas. I'm an anaesthetist in Canberra. My records show that I've done about 400 thyroid cases in the last few years. We have done our most challenging cases on the Mercy ships in West Africa, where gorda is endemic. Like most surgery, thyroidectomy requires a careful and a patient surgeon. The incision follows the neck creases and usually only a few centimetres long. Like ducks swimming, all of the action is usually out of sight. My surgeon uses an Alexis retractor, two rings connected by a polyurethane tubing which retracts the wound edges and also serves to protect them. Meticulous hemostasis and provocation with a Valsalva manoeuvre at the end is the final check for bleeding before closure. Most goiter in Australia is due to nodular thyroid disease. Most patients present with benign multinodular goiter and are euthyroid at presentation. Iodine deficiency is emerging as a contributory cause in Australia. Other causes of goiter are, of course, autoimmune disease, Hashimoto's disease with the presence of antithyroid antibodies, and Grave disease, where antibodies bind to TSH receptors and stimulate the production of T3 and T4. As I said, goiter is endemic in many areas of Africa where its causes are multifactorial. Iodine and selenium deficiency and other influences such as soybeans or cassava in the diet are goitrogenic. Also, genetics play a part. There, poor access to timely and affordable surgical care result in the very large goiters that are seen. Airway distortion by goiter is common, but usually intubation is easy, even for the very large thyroids. For those, I film the CT scan to get an idea of the path of the airway. We've only had one sternotomy for a retrosternal component the size of a small kitten in the last 10 years or so. The patient only complained of mild dyspnea and was intubated with a size 4 laryngoscope and a bougie. Thyroid storm or thyrotoxic crisis, seen more commonly a few decades ago, is now extremely rare since patients have much better control of their disease, particularly Graves disease. All organ systems are affected by thyroid hormones. In the setting of surgery, the symptoms to watch out for relate to the central nervous system and manifest as agitation or seizures, and the cardiovascular system, where tachycardia, AF, and cardiac failure are seen. There are gastrointestinal hepatic manifestations, and thermoregulation effects are reflected in a rise in temperature. There is a point system that is sensitive but not specific to determine whether thyroid storm is likely or unlikely. The treatment of thyroid storm or symptomatic thyrotoxicosis is supportive. Patients are given oxygen, they're monitored with respect to their cardiac system, and cooling is initiated. Tachycardia is usually managed with beta blockade with IV agents and calcium channel blockers for those who can't tolerate beta blockade. Digoxin can be used for atrial fibrillation and the beta blockers will help with rate control. Specific treatment is aimed at inhibiting new thyroid hormone synthesis with methimazole or propylthiouracil. And the problem with that is that these are available only orally. And inhibiting thyroid hormone release with Lugol's iodine or potassium iodide. Peripheral conversion of T3 to T4 can be prevented with hydrocortisone or dexamethasone. If there is hypertension, which is not common, nitrate should be avoided since thyrotoxicosis is associated with vasodilation and a decrease in SVR. Amiodarone has the issue that it can precipitate thyroid storm and interfere with thyroid status. As far as anaesthesia goes, anything is possible under local anaesthesia, but thyroidectomy is rarely, if ever, done under local anaesthesia or a regional block.
Well, that's all we can share with you from this video out of respect to our generous contributors. If you'd like to access the full video library and more, you can do so by visiting the ASA website. You'll need to be a member of the Australian Society of Anaesthetists. To find out more, follow the links in the notes below. In the meantime, thanks for watching and let's enjoy some music from one of our talented members, Dr. Mark Seuss.